Lake Louise is a world-class skiing and snowboarding destination in the Canadian Rockies of Alberta. Part of Banff National Park, it is the third largest ski resort in Canada. Much of the terrain is in the back bowls, with some of the most challenging riding in Canada. The resort receives 190 inches of average annual snow. The snowfall varies year to year, but the ski season lasts for 6 months from early November to early May.
Every lift has green, blue, and black run options, so groups with different abilities can easily spend the day together. Plus, Parks Canada just approved a significant redevelopment plan that includes new beginner and intermediate terrain, lift upgrades, and new buildings, which will transform the resort in the near future. We are Jeff and Jennifer with Snowboard Traveler. Welcome to the SkiBig3 Resort of Lake Louise.
Lake Louise is a two-hour drive from Calgary International Airport or 40 minutes from the town of Banff along the Trans-Canada Highway. It's a popular day trip from Calgary, and there are several parking lots close to the base. But they fill up, so arrive early to beat the crowds. From the base area of Whiskey Jack Lodge and the Lodge of the Ten Peaks, there are two options up the front side of the mountain. The four-person Grizzly Express gondola takes you to the top of Ptarmigan Ridge for long groomers and fun glades with incredible views of Mount Temple, Mount Victoria, and more on a clear day.
Your alternative from the base is Glacier Express, a high-speed quad lift that passes over the enormous terrain park. There are well-maintained features for all levels, from beginner to extra-large advanced jumps. This lift drops you off at the observation deck, where you can pause for photos of some of the best views of Banff National Park and the actual Lake Louise.
That's not the top yet. The top of the world six-person lift zips up to the ridgeline, where you will feel like you are indeed on the top of the world. This exposed area has variable weather conditions, but the snow fences help with navigation when visibility is low. Drop into the front side for long groomers following the World Cup race courses. You can also access Summit Platter Lift, which takes you to the highest point on the resort, Mount Whitehorn. The platter lift can be intimidating with the large crowd of people lined up, but the lifties are helpful. Ride it now while you can, as the resort has plans to replace it with a quad lift. The platter follows a black run straight up to spectacular 360-degree views on bluebird days. The summit can also be soft in or very windy on snowy days.
From the top of Mount Whitehorn, you have your pick of powder bowls on the back side of the mountain. This area is 60% of the resort. It's mostly black and double black lines with a couple green and blue trails winding through. Off the platter lift, drop into Whitehorn Bowl Blacks or the Ultimate Steeps Extreme Chutes. Loop around to Boomerang Bowl for exceptional blacks or traverse to the extreme chutes of Hector Ridge. I took the intermediate boomerang run given the snow conditions, which was still powdery with boulders at the bottom of the steeps. All the runs in the back funnel down to a green run, so keep up your speed as a snowboarder to make it to the Paradise Triple Chair.
This lift takes you to the top of Paradise Bowl with extreme chutes to the left and the right or steep black runs straight down. There's a green road that winds around Saddleback Bowl, so it is paradise for every ability. Paradise Bowl holds powder and is a perfect area for laps. A run here isn't complete without some turns through the Pika Glades filled with nicely spaced larch trees that have a similar feel to aspen glades. Larch trees are one of the few coniferous trees that change color and lose their needles in winter. All runs lead back to Paradise Lift, or you can continue to Ptarmigan Lift, the last area on the back, to reach steep glades. This slope faces the sun and can be crunchy without new snow, but the glades are amazing with the right conditions.
The last section of the resort is the Larch area, accessed by the high-speed Larch Quad. Larch is a catch-all of fun surprises with groomed runs, steep glades, and the rock garden, a must-see area. Take the trail and the lift left through the trees, which opens up into a field of massive boulders. Piled high with snow, they turn into powder pillows and natural moguls to ride over and through. This is by far our favorite run at Lake Louise.
The top of Larch is where you can boot pack up to find powder stashes. The climb is steep and challenging, but you can drop in anywhere along the route into elevator shaft for fresh turns through blue tinted snow. This brings you right back into the rock garden area. If you continue hiking to the top, you can access backcountry terrain such as Purple Bowl or Wolverine Bowl. This terrain will be out of bounds in the future, so take advantage while you can.
It's easy to work up an appetite, and at the bottom of Larch is the Temple Lodge. It has a barbecue and smokehouse with indoor and outdoor seating, cafeteria food, and specialty dining upstairs in Sawyer's Nook. Another dining spot on the front side mid-mountain is Whitehorn Lodge. This restaurant is recently renovated and serves mountain cuisine, enhanced by amazing views off the patio.
After a full day exploring the front and back of Lake Louise, head down to the base for après. Relax on the Kokanee Cabin deck with a pint or head into the Lodge of the Ten Peaks for sushi at Kumayama. You can also drive over to the actual Lake Louise for a scenic tour and specialty drinks at the seasonal ice bar.
There is a mountain there. This is Jennifer and Jeff with Snowboard Traveler. I think they allow snowmen into the chateau. We'll find out because we're pretty much snow people right now.
See you next time.
See you next time.